We walk around with this information that has been given to us by people who have no interest in you knowing what's really going on. But just know, the government is putting out a whole lot of psychological operations to keep you worried. You know why? Because a worried populace is more easier to control. We gotta do better. They controlling us.
But I'm not asleep right now. I'm awake. I want to welcome you back to another Real Talk session with your man Theodore Smiles.
The world has been beguiled. Have you guys seen what was going on in the Netherlands? The farmers over there are rising up. Because the World Economic Forum and the Prime Minister in that country is trying to make them the first to fall in the dominoes of things that's going to cause our world as we know it, our society as we know it, to collapse.
Traffic is at a standstill in many parts of the country. After blocking highways with dirt, the Dutch farmers are sending out these messages. Our land is not for sale. You only get this pile of dirt. You want our land? Take it. After the United protest in Amsterdam, the Dutch farmers' uprising has reached another level. They are rising up stronger and more crowded in response to the starvation policy instituted by Mark Rutte's regime. Right now, they're rising up in many parts of the Netherlands. While a huge group is heading to Den Haag, the other group using manure, hay bales, wheat, sand, and whatever possible to block highways A1 in Basman, A12 in Bernic, A30 in E, A35 in Henglo, and A50 in Eindhoven. The Dutch citizens also support the farmers' protest. Thousands have come out to show support wherever the Dutch farmers go. Many people in the Netherlands start to see this as a revolution because their farmers have been doing a great thing to stop the Great Reset. In the last few days, the Dutch farmers have sent a clear message to the Dutch government. If you serve the global elite, if you follow the Agenda 2030, if you want to take our land and places under the control of the state, then we don't want you anymore. The protests will continue. There will be actions the Netherlands had never seen before. More highways will be blocked. This is not stopping until you, the government, backs down.
We have been lucky over here in America to be able to be insulated against the atrocities that humanity faces on a daily basis. If you lived in Africa or some of these other countries that you can't even pronounce, Czechistans and Icelands and European countries and Asian countries, America has been number one for a long time. Guys, our country is being intentionally gutted. I believe that China is next in line to become the world's superpower. Well, that's what the elite want. Or, maybe I'm wrong. That's just what they want us to think. But I know one thing. For Biden to send over America's oil reserves to China and our conspiratorial media not to even really make much of a blip of the media story.
selling U.S. oil reserves to China. It's happening, and it's coming under heavy scrutiny. The company buying the oil has ties to Hunter Biden. Business magnate Bill Gates has reportedly sponsored a Chinese program to recruit foreign scientists. That's amid heightened alarm over the Chinese Communist Party's threat to the Western world.
I feel like that is an atrocity. Why have this cult of death reached every corner of power? Why have the real men and women of strength who care about our society rose up and did a damn thing about it? My point is this, man. Hug your family. Be your own media. Take the time to figure out what's really going on. Use critical thinking. Do not accept the common day narrative given to you by the media, such as CNN, ABC, NBC, ABC, all these different letter agencies. Keep in mind and remember that all media is owned by six corporations. These numbers that you see on media all the time, they reoccur, and it's all a plan. They use numbers to hide their agenda and inform their members, because I'm about you and your family, because you and your family are my family, because the ideas I'm able to birth within you are my children, as I don't have any children, never been married. So my legacy, my mark on society, is what I'm able to cultivate within you. And that's why you are so important to me. You guys are like my farmland. You guys are my soul line. And I will do all that I can to cultivate you properly. I want to salute you. I love you.